Wisconsin lawmakers have a new plan to get people help, get people trained, and get people working.
We need more people in the workforce.
Right now, companies are struggling to hire qualified workers, even when there are plenty of applicants. Those applying either don't have the right skills or aren't able to pass a drug test. Last week, we talked about Fast Forward, a program that gives grants for worker training.
There are businesses throughout the state right now that are just begging for good technicians.
But what about workers struggling with drug addiction? New efforts would require drug screening and testing for some people on unemployment insurance. Unemployment benefits are designed to help while workers find a new job. They can't find that new job if drug use prevents them from being hired. The new program would get people treatment so they can get back on track and off government assistance. These treatments could save lives and even save money by avoiding a cycle of drug use, government dependence, and the inability to gain employment.
People don't wake up in the morning say, I want to be on government assistance. They wake up in the morning saying, you know, I want to go out and get a gainful employment. I want to feel good about myself. If we provide that help, that's what this is about.
Unemployment insurance is supposed to be temporary, a stopgap while workers search for work. With the new rules, state benefits could be held back if candidates can't pass a drug test, but they'd be restored when the worker attends treatment and training.
I was a human resources person for over 30 years. Getting people to be able to pass a drug test was an issue, particularly when unemployment gets very low, which unemployment now in the state is about 4.4%. When that starts to drop, it's even harder for employers to find qualified skills. And part of that qualified skills, meaning being able to pass a drug test to ensure, and the purpose for that is they want safe workers, they want productive workers, don't want people that, you know, have potential issues.
The rules wouldn't drug test everyone on unemployment insurance, just in industries where being drug-free is critical for job success, all to help them find a job and fill some of the 85,000 openings currently available in our state. We'll see you next week for another 2-Minute Drill.